everybody, this is Kim from K Diamond Paints, and I have some diamond paintings to show you from a new to me company. I was contacted by Wendy from DIY Choose, and she offered me some diamond paintings for free for an honest review for you, and I am so excited.
They're here.
I am really excited about these diamond paintings because normally when I choose diamond paintings, things like that, I mean, I always choose something that I would be excited to do, but normally I choose with the review in mind, with the purpose of finding things that maybe everybody would like. However, when I went onto this site, DIY Choose, I found some that I personally liked. And so I chose these really selfishly, specifically for me. Okay, so you can see there's three diamond paintings. I'm excited about all of them. This one looks a little flatter, so I think we'll start with this one. We'll put these two to the side for now. The shipping time on these was great. I was sent a tracking number, and they were sent out on February 18th. They arrived March 2nd for 12 days. I think that's pretty... I'm all thumbs. Pretty spectacular. You can see it tucked away in there. Looking glorious already. I'm excited already, right? But as I said, I chose these. So this one, I can see what it is already. I know what you're going to say. So it comes with a standard kit. I would consider this a very standard kit. And here's the packaging. Well, the packaging has kind of everything you want to need, you ever need. The corresponding number, the DMC. There we go. Oh, and the canvas number. That's what I was trying to say. Look at the pretty colors though. Can you see? There you go. Okay, when you see this one, I know what you're going to say. You're going to say, Kim, that's not even the right season. And what I'm going to say to you is, I don't even care. Because look! Can you see? Let me straighten it for you a little bit. It's friends, you guys! You're just going to have to imagine the music because I can't play that without getting a copyright strike, so use your
imagination.
But look at this. Aren't they adorable? Friends, I have one of the greatest gifts I was ever given. My mother-in-law gave me the box set of the entire Friends, you know, every season. This beautiful box set. And I think I watched that every day, 2 years straight. I watched it round and round and round. I love Friends. Okay, let's get into this. So it's a canvas, you know, just the stiff canvas. But look at this key, you guys, 30 by 40. Look at the thumbnail. I'll put the thumbnail up here. I'll put the image up here as well for you to see. 30 by 40. Look at this key. So nice and clear. How many colors? 21 colors. You would think that you wouldn't need this many colors, right? It's like, is it 3? Yeah, 3, 8, 6, 5 and a little bit of stuff. But look at the lettering, looks clear. So if you see here on the canvas, there are no guide circles. The printing is just perfectly clear. There's some shading in there. They're adorable. Let's see what the stick is like. Ooh, this is, I bet we could skate with this. Have you ever done the skater glue where you can put a diamond down here and it's not exactly the right spot so you can skate it where you need it to be? So it's a little less sticky. It's going to get the job done though. Sometimes I like skater glue. Pretty good. Okay, let's check out the drills. Very excited. I'm sorry if I'm talking softly. I caught a cold. It was running around outside and I thought, look at that. I'll just catch it. Not too bad though. I haven't had a cold in over a year, right? Because of being confined and everything. So I guess my time was up. So we know we're going to get a ton of 3, 8, 6, 5. Let's take a look at them. These are pretty little drills. See, they look a little bit petite. Do you know what I mean? The slightly smaller drills. I love those. They're so cute and little. Okay. Is this a 154? Let's see. Sure enough is. I like 154. That's pretty. Can you see we got a little bit of a glare? There we go. Maybe that's better. I tilt it up. Oh, there we go. There's the pretty red for you. Here, let's move everything aside. There you go. Here, now we're on a roll. Oh, look at that color. Green, grays, burgundy. Oh, look at this orange. Pink, pink with everybody one. See, everybody likes pink. Look at everybody in there with pink. Some butter. That's some butter right there. Pink. Yes. So, okay, here's my first one. So, again, I know it's not Christmas anymore, but I don't care because it's friends. I'm probably gonna frame this one for the love of Pete. I love it. All right, on to the next one. Okay, this one I think a lot of people are going to love. I've been looking for one of these images to do. Whoops. And I saw this one and I thought, no, this is perfect. It's colorful, has everything I want. I can't wait to show it to you. So again, we have our typical toolkit. This is all you need. This pen, little boat, wax, and it'll get you going. Oh, see, look at the colors here. Very orange, brown color palette. Are you ready for this? It's a little bit shiny. It's a little bit shiny. How about if I do that? It's the Mandalorian, right? But look at this one. Because there's a lot with Grogu. Some of them I don't like his image, but this one with the colors and Mando, this one I just love. So when I saw this one, I'm like, oh no, this is the one I have been looking for. I love it. I love that show. Did you cry? I cried. I texted my sister-in-law. I said, did you cry? Because honestly, I teared up. I choked up at the end. I'm like, that can't be it. I was so excited. Here's the key again. We've got 20 colors. Lovely. And the canvas, super clear. Oh, look at his helmet. Looks fantastic. Little Grogu. So cute. Oh, I love this. Let's see if I can flatten it out a little bit. Let's see if the glue is the same on this. Yeah, it's not the stickiest. I think it's good. I have never had yet that super stick glue that people say you put it down and it stays down. I haven't had that yet. I think I will not have a lot of success with that. I'm interested to try because I'm such a sloppy drill placer. Everything I put down, I have to move around. There we go. But yeah, should we check out the drills? Oh, look at that. Isn't that fantastic, Mandalorian image? I love it. All right, let's look at these drills. Plus, I love these colors like peaches and oranges and stuff like that. That's just some of my favorites. Here we go. Oh, that's lighter than it's looking on screen there. I'm trying to get it. There we go. That's better. Oof. Is that 720, 740? I always forget which one's which. I think they're pretty close. Whoops. Why do I always forget that? Move it. There we go. Now we can focus. So these do have little divots in the back, these drills. Look at that. All the little divots. But these, as I said, these are just slightly petite feeling. Is that 817? What's 666? You guys, look at all that 666. Pretty reds. Oh. There we go. That's a pretty peach color too. All right. So that's for The Mandalorian. I have to do this one, right? Maybe I'll do, I don't know which one I'm going to do next. But I love this one. Absolutely love it. And it's a 30 by 40. It won't take too long, hopefully. That's, I say that. I think the last 30 by 40 took me like 2 months. So who am I kidding? Okay, here's the last one. I am so excited to show you this one because this is from an artist that I'm slightly familiar with and I love his artwork. So here's the issue with me slightly knowing this artwork is that I knew this artist, I knew a little bit about him, so I felt comfortable ordering this. So let me tell you, this is artist Ralph Cahoon. He was born in Cape Cod in 1910, and his family, look at this. So this is a, you can see this is bigger. This is 70 by 40. Look at the colors. Ocean colors, right? You can tell he's from Cape Cod. Where's the, there it is. Still a regular toolkit. You know what, though? I would say this is probably going to be a little bit difficult on this size to use this. You can, of course, do it, but I might get a grippy. You can get grippies from the dollar store. Put that on your pen for this size. A little hot tip. But his family, so born in Cape Cod, his family was in whaling and fishing, and he is an artist. He decided to go a different way. He's a very talented artist. And so, look. Can you see this? Let me try and lift it up. So you can see this beautiful, beautiful art. Well, I'm gonna raise you up. Hold on. There, isn't it beautiful? I believe this piece is called Sorcerer's Apprentice. He has a lot of these fanciful mermaid, fishing village scenes. They're all just so beautiful. I just love it. I have family that's from back that way, so I've been over there, and it just feels so original to that area, I guess is what I should say. So here's the thing. I thought I did my homework on this. As I said, I knew this artist. However, I think now that this piece was done in the 1950s. So I'm sorry. So it's not in the realm of public domain. It is not. And I thought it was. So that's on me that I, as I said, knowing the little bit that I did, I thought it was fine and I should have done my homework before I ordered. But I cannot be sorry because, as I said, I just love his artwork. And this is beautiful. So all their canvases, as you can see, are poured glue, which we all enjoy as just an easier way to go about our diamond painting than double-sided adhesive. I do have a video about how I deal with double-sided adhesive. I'll tag that for you if you're interested. So let me show you the key. I'm trying to get my hands on this. Here's the teeny tiny little thumbnail. Actually, let me just take the moment to fill the screen here with this piece of art because it's just such a glorious, oh, such a fun, whimsical image, isn't it? It's so beautiful. Here's the key, and again, super clear, easy to read symbols. Are they all letters? Yep, there's 22 colors. I thought at a 70 by 40, there would be a fighting chance for this to come out. You always have to make that trade-off between size and clarity in a diamond painting. Of course, everything would be glorious in 60 by 90, 75 by 100, but you have to say, do I really want to do that? So I'm trying to show you some of the, like the mermaids. I think the mermaids are going to come out. I think you're going to see them. The shadow of the little people in here. I'm interested. Can you see? Am I getting it there? The anchor right there. Maybe even that'll come out in the flags. It's just beautiful though. So maybe this is what I do next because look at that. It's just beautiful. I'll bring you back down and we'll take a look at the drills. Okay. His wife was an artist too, and you should go check them out. They have a museum that's dedicated to them, and everything is just like that. I saw a box up for auction. Oh, it was beautiful. It had their artwork around this box, this round carousel looking box. Look at these colors, this like muted Americana type of palette. And then how many colors? Anyone remember? Anyone? Anyone?
Bueller. Bueller.
22. 22 colors. So here we go. Oh, look at these blues. I would paint my house in these colors. Look at these. Lavender. Oh, sage greens. Look at this. What is this? It's like a perfect blue gray. I don't know what that is. What is that? Anyone? I won't do it twice in one. 535. Huh. I say that all the time in life. Does anyone have the milk? Anyone? Anyone? Anyone seen my pen? Anyone? Anyone? I mean, I say that around my house all the time. It's just nuts. We're all used to it here. Oh, look at that blue. There's so many in there too, right? They're stuffed full. Well, right, because it's a whole sea scene. So we got a whole host of these. And then here we go with our little bit of color. Oh man, dude, these are just the most beautiful pastel-y shades of blues and everything. Aren't they beautiful? Okay, so here they all are. I love them all. I'm really sorry I messed up the dates on this. You know, a little bit of knowledge can just jump up and... But I can't be sorry that I have it. I love him as an artist. I'm so excited to have this as a diamond painting. I'll have to do one of these because so far the quality looks great. The shipping time was wonderful. Their prices, as you can see, I put them up on the screen. The prices are really great. The drills look beautiful. So I'll have to do one of these and do a post review for you because so far everything looks really fantastic. Thank you again to Wendy from DIY Choose for giving me this opportunity to do this review for you. And yeah, you guys, we'll see you later, okay?